Ya Shweta Padmasana Ya Brahma Jutta Shantara Prapritibir Deve Sada Vandita Samambhatu Saraswati Bhagavati Vishesha Jaya Vaha.
Appreciates a good story of twists and turns, tragedy and triumph. One such story is of a great friendship. It is one of the greatest friendships that ever existed, but I'll let you be the judge of that. This friendship was between Lord Krishna and Draupadi, the queen of Indraprastha and wife of the five noble brothers, the Pandavas. Lord Krishna and Queen Draupadi shared a deep and affectionate friendship. Draupadi was devoted to Lord Krishna. She loved him immensely. She fought with him, she questioned him, and she turned to him in times of need. Are you ready to come on a journey with me?
Yes, we are.
Om Namo Narayanaya. Let us witness some incidences of this great friendship in the great Indian epic, the Mahabharata, that illustrate the deep love and devotion that Queen Draupadi had for Lord Krishna. Was this love enough for Lord Krishna? Om Namo Narayanaya. Om Namo Narayanaya. Om Namo Narayanaya.
So it shall be. However, there shall be no poet whose work shall surpass this one. Therefore, revered sage, let Shri Ganesha be this grammar.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Shri Ganeshaya Namaha. Om 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 Shri Ganeshaya Namaha.
Here I am.
Greetings, Shri Ganesha, and welcome. Please be seated. Oh, wise Ganesha, will you be the scribe of a poem which I will recite?
I shall be the scribe of your poem, but I have one condition. That you recite the verses without a pause.
I agree to your condition, and I have a condition of my own. That you will not inscribe anything if the meaning is not clear to you.
Om Shri Ganeshaya Namaha.
Tevama, I will have to ask you to test Rukmini's sugar levels after eating all this cake. Draupadi. I promise to always protect you when you are in trouble.
Lord of sweetness is entirely sweet.
Krishna
Draupadi became victim to the strict adherence of Dharma. When she needed protection the most, those who could have helped her failed to do so because of their strict, their inner conflict of Dharma. After a game of dice between the Pandavas and their cousins, the Kauravas, the Pandavas had staked their entire wealth, including their wife Draupadi, to the Kauravas, the eldest of the Kauravas being the deceitful Duryodhana.
Dushasana! Bring Draupadi down here to the assembly hall. Let her sweep our house. You have nothing to fear from the Pandavas.
Draupadi, King Yudhishthira has staked you in a game of dice with Duryodhana, and you have been won by Duryodhana. I've been asked to take you down to the assembly hall. Are you referring to King Yudhishthira? What type of king plays a game and gambles his wife away? Yudhishthira was certainly intoxicated with that dice. And could he not find any other object to stake? Go, ask that gambler, whom has he lost first, himself or me?
The king first staked all of his wealth, his brothers, himself, and then, Queen Draupadi, he staked you.
No, no, I'm not well. I am in my season. I only have this one garment, which is stained with blood. You cannot take me to the assembly hall.
Come, you have been virtuously won by us.
Assembled in the hall, Queen Gandhari, King Dhritarashtra, Sage Vidura, Sage Kapacharya, Dronacharya, and the grandsire Bhishma, but no one spoke. She looked at them with eyes desperate for help, but no one spoke. All the elders assembled in the hall remained silent, and their husbands sat with their heads lowered down.
You wretch! You rude one! You have no right to bring me to the assembly hall, where all our respected elders are present. I am in my season. I'm only wearing this one sari, which is stained with blood. Krishna, please, please rescue me. Krishna. Krishna.
Come to me. Come to me. You're my slave. You're my property. You're my slave and you belong to me. Dushasana, a servant does not need to have rich robes. Snatch her sari and disrobe her here and now.
Slave.
Please, save me. Yudhishthira, my father was faith, but you will always protect me, gave me to you. Today I'm being dishonored in this most dreadful way, and yet you sit there with your head down. You should be ashamed of yourself. You evil Duryodhana! You point your thigh to me, you will have death in your thigh. As Durshasana torments me now. Bhima will one day drink his blood. Grandsire Bhishma, someone told me that my husband lost himself at the game of dice, and then he stabbed me. I want someone to tell me if my husband was right in staking me after he lost himself.
Listen, lady. When someone has lost all of their wealth, it is wrong to stake the wealth belonging to another. But on the other hand, women are always at the command and disposal of their husbands. I am unable to give you an answer to your current situation. The ways of morality are subtle, and it's difficult to define dharma in this situation.
Durshasana, disrobe Draupadi now.
Krishna, do you not see how I'm being forcibly stripped, humiliated, and dishonored in the public by the Kauravas? Krishna, please save me. Save my honor, O Krishna. Save my honor.
Hold, Krishna. Hold.
Save my honor. Krishna, Lord of the universe, whom I adore and trust, please do not abandon me at this time. Please protect me as I give my life into your hands.
Oh, my Lord, come to me.
disappointment in her grandfather Bhishma, her pain, her anger, her concept of God. At her worst hour, at that time of humiliation, torture, abuse, she surrendered her life into God's hands.
Yes. When we are in trouble, what do we usually do? What do we turn to? What do we rely on? We usually turn towards our worldly support systems, our family, our friends. Queen Draupadi also first turned towards her external support systems. First, she turned towards her husbands. They were of no use. Then she turned towards the elders. They were also of no use while that monster was tearing off her sari. Then she turned towards her own inner strength. But that was also of no use. Finally, she had no choice but to give up, raise her arms in the air, and surrender to God. Then what happens?
Love will God envelops her.
Yes. Therefore, give up all worldly support systems and have ananyata, one-pointed devotion to God. In every seeker's life, there comes a time when all our worldly attachments fail. It is then, from deep within, that we surrender and turn towards God. Does that mean we should leave our worldly support systems? No, but we should remember it is God that is supporting us. It may appear as if the world is supporting us, but we must have faith and conviction within. Your spiritual seekers, may God your soul support. Are you ready to make the choice to go on this path?
Yes, but tell me how.
Om Namo Narayanaya, Om Namo Narayanaya, Om Namo Narayanaya, Om Namo Narayanaya. Om Namo Narayanaya, Om Namo Narayanaya, Om Namo Narayanaya, Om Namo Narayanaya. Renounce all desire, renounce all honor, abandon all worry, take refuge in the Lord. Om Namo Narayanaya, Om Namo Narayanaya, Om Namo Narayanaya, Om Namo Narayanaya. Don't depend on anything, not even on yourself. Take refuge in the Lord, you'll be in eternal bliss. Om Namo Narayanaya, Om Namo Narayanaya, Om Namo Narayanaya, Om Namo Narayanaya. Om Namo Narayanaya, Om Namo Narayanaya, Om Namo Narayanaya, Om Namo Narayanaya. Om Namo Narayanaya, Om Namo Narayanaya, Om Namo Narayanaya, Om Namo Om Namo Narayanaya, Om Namo Narayanaya, Om Namo Narayanaya.
sage Narada says that you are the creator and the lord of all. You are omnipresent and the self in all. For the love and affection that you have shown towards me, when you rescued me at a time when nobody else would, I shall tell you my griefs. I curse Duryodhana. I will wash my hair with the blood of Durshasana. And until then, I will not wash my, tie my hair. That is a promise. Krishna, how do a person like me, the queen of Indraprastha, the wife of the mighty Pandavas, and a friend of yours, be stripped, humiliated, and dishonored in the public assembly hall? I was wearing one single cloth sari in my season. My sari stained with blood. I was trembling, weeping. I was dragged by my hair into the assembly hall where all our respected elders were present. My husband, however weak, they should have protected me. Yet they abandoned me.
Draupadi, I know that you are deeply hurting. Let us look at your painful disrobing. Your true nature is bliss, just as you experienced when you surrendered to me. Your sari is the veil, the ego, and each layer which Dushasana has pulled off you represents your pain, anger, grief, expectations of your husbands and elders.
How do I get rid of this ego, this veil, this grief? If my true nature is bliss.
The devotee's mind is always established in God. Think of pain and grief as a gift from God. Rejoice in the suffering, welcome the pain. You will not forget God even for a second. Offer everything, your mind, heart, intellect, citta, at a higher altar. Completely surrender. I can be cruel at times and put my devotees through severe tests and trials only to bring them closer to me.
Krishna, I do worship you, but even if I worship you, these awful things still happen to me.
You think of me as separate from you. only thing that separates me from you is this veil. As long as this veil exists, surrender is not possible. I could not hear your cries of calling so long as you relied on your strength and depended on your husbands and elders. Only when you cried aloud in complete sincerity could I run to rescue you.
How do I live a life of true self-surrender?
Think of life as a labyrinth, and each light on the path represents difficulties you will encounter. Life is a journey to God. When you experience those difficulties, think of me. Call upon me. Surrender to me. I promise I am always with you. Journey to God ends when you and I are one.
Thank you.
Incident, Queen Draupadi was restored to the Pandavas, but they were put into exile and lived in the forest. Duryodhana, the eldest of the Kauravas, wanted to humiliate the Pandavas. He retained the grace of the great sage Durvasa. So he sent the sage Durvasa with his numerous disciples to the home of the Kauravas, unannounced, late one night.
Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya.
Draupadi, I see Sage Durvasa coming with his many disciples.
Pranam, Sage Durvasa. Welcome to our home. You must be very hungry after your long journey. You have some meals with us. We'll prepare the meals and you can go wash up and offer worship at the river. Draupadi, please prepare meals for Sage Durvasa and his many disciples.
Lord Yudhishthira, you know that I've already cleaned that special pot that allows me to cook enough food to feed all our families and friends. And after I've eaten, I cannot cook anymore. How am I going to fulfill my duty in serving our guests?
What am I to do? I've already invited them for meals.
Krishna, my Lord, you are my Saviour. Please, please help me, my Lord. Oh, Krishna. Krishna. Krishna.
Draupadi, please give me your bowl. I am hungry. I shall enjoy eating this one grain of rice.
Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Ooh, I feel so full and satisfied. I cannot think of taking any food now. King Yudhishthira, after bathing, we all feel as if we have had a sumptuous meal. We will come again some other day. Your righteousness will always protect you. Om Namah Shivaya.
Sage Durvasa and his many disciples have just left.
Sage.
saying they feel full and satisfied.
How can it be otherwise if the Lord Himself was satisfied?
Lord Krishna saw Queen Draupadi on numerous occasions and advised her and encouraged her. A woman whom Lord Krishna honored surely is worthy of being universally honored.
Lighting and